In this video, you get an overview of the different views and features in Tactplan. In the following section, you will learn different views in Tactplan: Flowline, Side Panel, Takt Time, Gantt, Network Diagram, Task Grid, Locations, and Calendars. We will briefly show completed schedule for the project Exego House. It is a small residential building with four staircases with 2 to 4 levels and a basement in each. In Flowline View, you get a full overview of the entire schedule. To the left, you will find locations, and in the top, you will find time. Tasks are shown in the middle. The Flowline View is used to add tasks and find areas where you can optimize your schedule. Among other things, you can see if there are situations where there are tasks at the same time and place, because the lines will then cross each other. You can zoom in and out by clicking on this. Define how much or how little of your schedule you want to see. Here you can draw new tasks on your schedule. In the sidebar, you have all the settings for each task. To bring up the sidebar, you can double click on a task. No matter which view you are in, the sidebar can appear. For each task, you can see the start and end date. The duration shows total duration of the task for all locations. In addition, you can see the total time span in calendar days and working days. Calendar refers to which calendar the task should follow. Paste in as soon as possible settings are very unique for location-based scheduling. We will give a detailed introduction to this in another training video. If you click here, you can choose which color the task should be. If you click on locations in the top, you can see where your tasks appears. You can select locations and turn on and off activities and also change their orders, just like we do here. It is actually also possible to split your tasks and then merge them again, just like we do here. If you click on dependencies, you can select predecessors and successors for the tasks. The way we work with dependencies on location level is unique in Tactplan, and we will give a deeper explanation in a later training video. You can choose which type of dependencies there should be. Here we start by choosing predecessors. And then we will choose a successor. We'll also choose which level it should be on and whether there should be time lag between tasks. And finally, whether there should be location delay. If you click on duration, you can see how long the durations are for each task per location. You can look at start and end date. You can look at duration and also constraint date. To your left, you find Takt Time. When you click on this, you have the locations to your left and the time in the top. You can open and close locations. Like this, you can both see the entire project as well as dive into a specific location. When you click on this one, you can add a task. You can also create dependencies between tasks, and you can drag in the length of tasks, just like this. It is also possible to duplicate an existing task. You can see all tasks in the Gantt diagram. You can unfold them and see the full list of activities of all locations. You can also see the start and end date, which you can sort by. Like it's possible to sort by duration and also by name. If you click on this one, you can add a task. You can also create dependencies here. And here you can duplicate a task. If you click on the network diagram, you can see all your tasks. It is possible to add tasks in your network diagram. You can also duplicate a task and auto-arrange your diagram. To your left, you find Task Grid. If you click on this, you can see all tasks and the information around them. You can see their locations. And you can also see their location level. You can see the start and end date. And you can sort by them. You can also see duration, if it's as soon as possible, and paste. And also the color and dependencies. You can add task and you can duplicate. Filtering and sorting can be selected at the top of each column. In locations, you set up the locations for the schedule. You can add location levels. And here you can add locations and sub-locations. To your left, you can click on calendars. Here you set up your work calendar. It determines which day you will start the week and how many hours a work day has. It is possible to add several calendars if your workers have different working hours. You type in the name, choose the days, when it starts and when it ends, and you simply click Save. You can also delete a calendar. In this training video, you have learned the different views in Tactplan: Flowline, Side Panel, Takt Time, Gantt, Network Diagram, Task Grid, Locations, and Calendars. Thanks for watching. For more training videos, go to tactplan.com and make Tactplan your new favorite planning tool.